Welcome back, everyone, to theCUBE here in our Palo Alto studios. I'm John Furrier, host of theCUBE with Dave Vellante, my co-host, also co-founder. Dave, 16 years doing theCUBE, interviewing leaders here. Robotics and AI infrastructure is the focus. 3 days event, of course, with the NYSE Wired community. We had the Rosewood event yesterday. Aaron Fulkerson is here, CEO of Opaque, CUBE alumni, good friend. Great to see you. Thanks for coming on. Appreciate it.
Wonderful to see you guys again. It's always a pleasure.
So the leaders are all here talking, and the focus has been, okay, chips, software, a little bit of geography, sovereign cloud conversation, but the wave of agents coming is clear. Security, the role of data is huge. You guys are at the middle of it. Talk about what you guys are working on now and how you fit in there, because security is everywhere. Security is a data problem. Securing the LLMs, we had our last guest here, making a lot of business from Scale AI because they went with Meta. Little trust issue there. So there's a lot of trust, quality problems, evaluation. What's your focus on that?
The trust layer is a missing component of the internet that Vint Cerf's been talking about for 30 years. The reality is that, you know, he one of the things he said he regretted was that he wished he'd built in a cryptographic layer into the network, which allows you to have an identity and trust layer. During this first phase of the internet, which is a human internet, it was manageable. You could have organized bad actors, but we could buffer them out of the systems because humans operate at a rate-limited human speed. But with agents, it's very different. When we're talking about agents, we're looking at these things that are self-replicating and they have human-like capabilities, but quite different from humans. They operate at machine speed. So that creates a whole new demand for a trust layer in our infrastructure that is, it's not a survivable gap anymore. It has to get built into it.
I mean, trust has been kicked around as an abstraction, not as a primitive or first principle. What are customers doing to deal with this right now? Because the change management piece of a big conversation we're getting involved in, but also the structural changes in the industry happening. What are they doing?
So there's a lot that's been done over the last 10 years to build primitives that allow you to build a trust fabric that's globally scalable across the network. In fact, you've seen all of the largest technology companies build this as part of a confidential AI stack. Mm-hmm. So Apple's got it with their private cloud compute. Meta has it with their private processing for WhatsApp that they just announced in April-ish. Microsoft's been a real leader in building confidential AI capabilities internally for their internal services.
Amazon.
Amazon's got it with Nitro Enclave. So they provided the primitives to do this. There's just new awareness that because of this demand from AI agents that suddenly everybody's clamoring for it. And it's exactly what Opaque does. What Opaque allows you to do is to deploy what all of the biggest technology companies have built around confidential agents or confidential trust layer where you have cryptographic guarantees that are provable that one, this is in fact the agent that I expect, and it's got verifiable integrity from a hardware attestation to two, during the processing, it's processed in an encrypted environment with cryptographic guarantees. And then three, post facto, you have an attested audit trail signed by the hardware. And we do this for ServiceNow, we do it for Encore Capital, we do it for a bunch of enterprise companies, but what it allows them to do is to have a turnkey deployment for confidential AI that previously was only accessible to the world's largest technology companies.
So I think about Nitro and Nitro Enclaves. We at one point called it like a secret weapon, and then of course other hyperscalers followed suit. You saw VMware with Project Monterey, supposedly that's still alive, but you haven't heard much about it. So now you're filling that gap for any non sort of hyperscale environment, or do you live alongside the hyperscale environment?
No, we deploy inside the hyperscalers as well or on premise. The thing that's changed is 10 years ago, Intel came out with a new kind of microchip called SGX, and it's called confidential computing. It was pioneered with Azure and Intel and also the UC Berkeley Rise Lab, where Opaque spun out of. Yeah. But since then, it's every microchip manufacturer offers these confidential guarantees. NVIDIA released it with H100s.
ARM
has it, AMD, NVIDIA. Any of the major chip manufacturers have these confidential capabilities, and all of the hyperscalers now expose primitives for you to build a confidential stack. But there's a big difference between having confidential computing, which is kind of like tires on a car, versus a car, which I'm using an analogy to describe confidential AI. So it takes the properties of the microchips and exposes these guarantees through hardware attestation and key management handoff to provide verifiable guarantees that creates a trust layer.
Yeah, you're building value on top of that.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. So you look at like Meta with the private processing, perfect example, there was a good paper published about this where you can now run LLMs confidentially on your WhatsApp messages, where they can prove to you that they cannot see your messages, but you get the benefit of running LLMs. So the same is true for ServiceNow or insurance providers that we have as customers, where they want to take advantage of, let's say, confidential RAG. We just made an announcement this week at the Confidential Computing Summit, which is an event that we host. There's a lot of overlap between your guys' event as well as our Confidential Computing Summit. AMD, NVIDIA, ARM, Intel, Microsoft, they were all there making product announcements. Anthropic made product announcements around confidential AI on Tuesday as well. Anyway, the point of this is that you can have guarantees that you cannot see the information even though you're using AI features.
Describe the difference between private AI and confidential AI, because I love this topic, because confidential compute's been around. We've seen storage and compute separate. That creates advantages. Data AI, this is data AI confidentiality here.
Well, it's guarantees around the model weights are kept private, and it's also guarantees around data policy, regulatory compliance, and that your data is kept private. So private AI generally means that you're hosting it yourself within your own environment. So that's great. You know, Cohere and others are doing this. They'll brand it around private or secure AI. Confidential is an entirely different set of guarantees. If you think about what's happening in the market today, is you're seeing people who are building agentic workflows around discrete internal use cases that create optimization around routine decision-making or tasks. Well, okay, you know, there's some sensitive data flowing across these agentic systems that are probabilistic. If it's just the simple workflow, maybe that's all right, even if it's sensitive. In some spaces like ServiceNow, insurance, and financial services, they're like, even that, I have to have guarantees. I have to have provability that my data isn't leaked. But where we're going is much bigger than that. Yeah. Each one of these workflows are getting chained together into composite agentic systems.
Yeah.
Well, how do you protect your data in that situation and have it provable?
Yeah.
And then as this becomes an agentic web, where there's going to be far more traffic on the network from agents than there will be from humans, how do you know that your data's kept private and there's not a malicious actor or maybe an unintentional leak somewhere in that chain? Without these guarantees, you would never know.
And that's why the rise of OLTP, Dave, is because this transactions happen with the agents. So much activity, traffic. It's interesting because now when you look at like what we've been riffing on our last Cube pod, Dave and I always like to argue about these trends. We were talking about the fact that will agents have SLAs? And the answer is yes.
Yeah,
they will.
They'll be cryptographically enforced and provable both before, during, and after. Is how it's going to work. And we're already seeing.
And you guys are the bridge there, because this is where I think this
it takes a whole ecosystem. Yeah. Like there's no way Opaque can build the trust layer for the internet.
Explain how we get to a SLA, because soon these will be working for on behalf of tasks that will be paid for at some point.
Yeah, absolutely.
Or paid for in some form.
So it takes a whole ecosystem, and the ecosystem has to involve obviously the hardware innovators. It has to involve the hyperscalers. It has to involve the frontier model labs. It has to involve independent software vendors that are building. It has to involve the enterprise deployers, Accenture and McKinsey. All of these people were represented at the Confidential Computing Summit. So it was the CTO of McKinsey. It was the global data lead for Accenture. There was every microchip manufacturer, every hyperscaler. DeepMind was there, Anthropic was there. Everybody's coalescing around reference architectures that provide you these cryptographic and provable guarantees. Yeah. And that's what it's going to take.
That's a great trend, by the way, Aaron. That's just a great trend, because in all these waves, de facto standards have to emerge.
Absolutely.
What are you seeing on that? Are people rallying around certain things? Can you share more on that?
Yeah, these de facto or are they de jure standards?
So right now what's happening is they're not our standards, right? They're not Opaques. We have our own reference implementation that we've done with a bunch of large enterprise companies. Accenture's got theirs. They've adopted Opaques because Accenture's an investor in Opaque, and they're doing multiple deployments using our reference architectures. It's slightly different from what Azure's doing, which is slightly different from what Google Cloud's doing. Anthropic just announced this week a reference architecture as well. So everybody kind of has their own reference architecture, and what we were discussing at the summit is, okay, we need to make sure that we can take this zero trust chain from the hardware out to an MCP endpoint or an A2A endpoint, have a registry that you can look up against to verify the integrity of an agent you're interoperating with, and we've got to have standards around all of this. Yeah. So everybody's coming together literally this week, and we've made a commitment over the next 12 months. All right, let's start building out reference architectures that we agree upon and putting them out in the open.
Which part of the value chain is responsible for the mathematical provability?
So it's the root of trust comes from the actual microchip. Yep. So it's the root of trust is bound within the CPU or GPU that has a trusted execution environment. Baked into the silicone is an encryption key. And then each user's data, they hold their own encryption key, and there's a confidential mesh, effectively, that allows you to orchestrate the handoff of these keys into the encrypted cache inside the silicone where the data gets processed with these guarantees.
Right, got it.
So it takes the whole ecosystem, but the root of trust begins with the hardware.
I have to ask the question, because obviously AI infrastructure leaders have been here all week. Overhead, latency, performance, how is that addressed? Can you talk about some of the,
right now the overhead and NVIDIA, Intel, AMD, ARM, they all have published papers on this, as does Google and Azure. They're posting performance hits of single digit percentages. So it's less than 10%, certain workloads, it's a little bit more than 10%. Everybody claims it's gonna get down to 1-2% performance overhead. Now, you might think, well, what about the performance hit? Well, do you guys remember when we go to a conference and get on the public Wi-Fi and log into our email or bank accounts without an SSL cert on the network? That was only like 12 or 15 years ago.
Yeah.
It was insanity, right?
Plain text flying around.
There's all this plain text flying around on the network, and then you're at like an open source conference or a black hat conference. People are like, hey, this is your login and password. Yeah. The same thing is gonna happen. We know that with HTTPS, there's a 1-2% performance hit. There's gonna be
You gotta deal with that. And by the way, the hardware's getting smarter too. So,
absolutely.
So we're seeing a little bit of step function in the gain on the performance. This is why we had the chip conversation.
It's de minimis, and we've certainly seen with virtualization, it got there. You know,
every trend.
Yep. VMware. But this is just gonna be the standard.
It's minuscule compared to the value.
Absolutely
correct. Because SLAs, this is something that's not what's talked about in ages, but it's coming fast.
I mean, here's the reality. You guys know this, the listeners know this, is we have a global crisis of trust. And it's across every institution, every system, every infrastructure, whether it's technological, governmental, or societal. And us technologists have helped contribute to this global crisis of trust. The reality is, it's not going to get better until it gets a little bit worse.
Yeah.
AI is going to make this worse.
Yeah.
So we have to solve this problem of having a network trust layer.
Yeah.
It has to be solved.
And that's why everybody's collaborating, because they know.
That's why everybody's collaborating.
It's a
deal breaker.
They have to.
Absolutely.
Well, they have to, because if they don't, then everyone loses.
Yeah.
So and we've seen this in many ways. I mean, we saw it in open systems around network protocols. So I think the consensus has to get there, because at the end of the day, if you look at AI, the speed is so fast in terms of the velocity of the
human-like capabilities at machine speed. You can have a single agent in 1 hour accomplish what an entire group of people couldn't accomplish in a year.
Yeah.
It can take down a network, it can take down a power grid, it can cause a nation state event. So this trust layer is actively being built across.
And people
all
want
of the
people love agents. They love the promise of it, but they also have fear, and the confidence is not there, the enthusiasm there. But no one wants agents running around shipping code into production. They want to know that it's trusted, it's been delegated the task, it's being managed. This is what we're hearing about evaluations.
Well, Jason from Anthropic announced at our summit on Wednesday, so yesterday. He said 60-65% of the code at Anthropic is written by Claude. He projects that by the end of the year, it will be 90-95% of the code at Anthropic will be written by Claude.
Mm-hmm.
So it's an exciting time we live in, but it's also one that, you know, oh, by the way, another thing. They dropped on Wednesday, Jason announced it at the summit. I'm sure it was announced other places. An ASL3 model. So that is a artificial intelligence security level 3, which has they base it off of nuclear, cyber, and biological capabilities. Yeah. And they're particularly concerned about its biological capabilities and how it can augment and create some really dangerous things. So they've built into the model some guardrails to prevent this from happening, but Anthropic and DeepMind and everybody who's transparent are deeply concerned about the capabilities of these agents.
Yeah.
So again, it just goes back to, we have to have a trust layer because we have to be able to put some, not just assurances or legal contracts around this or some governmental regulation. That's not trust, that's hope. You have to have it baked into the fabric of the network, into the hardware.
Awesome. What's going on with Opaque? Talk about the conference. Give a quick plug for what you guys are working on. Great mission, totally endorsed here. What's going on?
Well, we did a product announcement around a new version of our platform that allows you to do confidential agents for RAG. It's a bunch of pre-built workflows where you can call against other back office systems that are commonly sensitive or confidential enterprise data, and then use that as part of an agentic workflow for RAG. And then we also announced that we joined the Cisco Outshift Agency Foundation, where they're building an open stack for agents. And I know, Dave, we saw each other at the Cisco Live event.
Yep.
We were talking about this earlier. This seems like a really ripe opportunity for Cisco to be incredibly relevant, because you have to build this into the network.
Totally, and they're bringing AI to the network, they're bringing their security to the network, and G2 is leading, and he's a builder.
Yeah.
Right, but my takeaway here, this is not a niche. This is
mainstream.
Compulsory for mainstream enterprises and for any AI pipeline.
Yeah. It's absolutely correct, yes.
Well, Aaron, we're really grateful for you to come on your busy day. Thanks for coming by and sharing. Confidential AI will be standard, it has to be. And again, we support you and the industry. Thanks for putting that together.
Thank you both for having me, and it's always a pleasure to chat with you both.
Awesome. The Cube here with the NYSE Wired community. I'm John Furrier. Dave Vellante, thanks for watching.